Well, some welcome news from the Centers for Disease Control today.
Medical reporter Dina Baer outlines new guidelines and some concerns eased about the vaccines.
The vaccines are working so well, fully vaccinated people can ditch their masks and hug their loved ones. 1 year after the lockdowns, a sign of recovery as some people can get close again with no concern about quarantining. But there has been some concern about the way vaccines were made. Still, religious leaders say, have faith and get your shot at normalcy. They grow rapidly and naturally divide.
And they're sort of naturally want to keep dividing and dividing because you go from one cell to a baby. In 9 months, those cells are dividing pretty rapidly.
Fetal-derived cells are used by scientists all over the world. At Northwestern Medicine, Dr. Thomas Hope studies a form called HEK cells for HIV research.
The one that most everyone uses in their labs, I have it in my lab. They are not sure of the circumstances of that. That one, I think, goes back to the 70s in the Netherlands. These things were done decades ago. And they're now just common materials, and HEK cells are probably in 75-80% of the labs at Northwestern where I work, where people are using cells to study in the lab.
They played a critical role in bringing COVID-19 vaccines to the masses to make the vector or carrier that delivers the spike protein to our cells upon injection. Johnson & Johnson used a fetal cell line that dates back decades.
That one was derived also in the Netherlands in 1985. I think it goes back to, and that was from an elective abortion, and that material was donated to these researchers who took some of the cells and did try to generate cell lines.
Pfizer and Moderna utilized the cells to test their vaccines.
You have to be sure it is getting into the cell and making the spike protein and functioning as it should. And so to do that, you have to have a human cell line. Are fetal cells going into me here? No, under no circumstances are there. Are there pieces of fetal cells being injected into me? No, that's not what is going on. And so I think it's important that everyone understand the details.
Given the origin of the cells used during research, the Vatican and Chicago's Archbishop Cardinal Blaise Cupich have issued public guidance when it comes to the vaccine.
I have my card.
Wonderful.
And I take this occasion to encourage everyone to become vaccinated. And when their time comes, I want to make it clear to Catholics and everyone else that they can receive whatever vaccine is offered to them with a clear conscience.
Even as an insider, just to see how we went from not really knowing this virus existed to having vaccines and potentially vaccinating the US by the time we get to summer is just remarkable. It's an amazing achievement, and that could not have happened without these fetal-derived cell lines.
And now the unthinkable has happened. The Centers for Disease Control Monday announcing fully vaccinated people can gather indoors without a mask.
Fully vaccinated people can visit with other fully vaccinated people indoors without wearing a mask or physical distancing. Visit with unvaccinated people from a single household who are at low risk of severe COVID-19 disease indoors without wearing masks or physical distancing.
That's because science shows those fully vaccinated people do not asymptomatically spread COVID-19 and therefore carry little risk to others. A little more than 9% of people in the U.S. are fully vaccinated. And even though some are getting their privileges back, experts warn those who are not vaccinated still need to wear masks and socially distance.